but I just can't make a sound. You tell me that you need me, then you go and cut me down.
So welcome to Performer Stuff Pro Series, which is a collaborative forum where working professionals can share together their knowledge, experience, hopefully a little wisdom, but most importantly, their collective passions for live entertainment. I'm Mark Pawsey, and today I will be hosting a roundtable discussion with members of MDC3 from NBC's World of Dance, Diego, Madison, and Emma. Welcome. First question, what inspires you about dancing? Let's start with you, Emma.
I just like knowing that I can like share what I love to do to people, and I think we always try to tell a meaningful story. So just knowing that it touched someone really makes like my day, and it makes dancing like a lot more fun.
So where do you collect those stories? What stories inspire you to tell us?
We get like a bunch of stories basically from what we've been going through personally, or I mean, we haven't really been like, we are not dating each other.
Or we can relate to like what people in the world are feeling, and that like inspires us as well.
Like relatable stories that the audience can understand through our dancing.
And how did it feel when those doors opened and you walked through and you saw the panel? Diego, let's start with you. You were the last one to react.
I was very surprised because we had no idea that they were there the whole like weekend that we were there. And yeah, it was just like a whole like amount of emotions, and it even pushed us even more.
Good. Emma, how about you?
Well, I was just like so nervous already walking in. Like you can, if you watch the video closely, and like I'm holding my hands, you could see me mouth, oh my God, like we're going out.
Yeah, I wanted to throw up.
Yeah, and just like walking through the doors, I was like, okay, I have to be confident. And then I saw them and I was like, oh no. What the heck? And it was just like not really real. Like it didn't feel real at all. They look like projectors. Like it's crazy. But I think it like helped me dance harder, because when I get nervous, I do better. So it helped me.
It was definitely crazy walking out and seeing them, because we were preparing ourselves for like a couple weeks, like, oh, it's going to be producers. Like it won't be as nerve wracking as having the judges in front of us. But when we walked out and saw them, it was definitely threw me off a little bit at first, but it pushed me to go even harder while we danced.
Did you learn anything about yourselves and in that audition? And if so, what was it, Emma?
I learned that I could do anything I like try to do, like if I don't hold myself back, because I think I hold myself back a lot and get in my head. And just like going through that process really pushed me and gave me the confidence like that I needed, I think.
Madison.
I definitely learned that confidence is super important to stay successful in a dance career, because if you lose confidence in yourself, then you can't really perform to your best ability. So staying confident was definitely an important part for me in the whole process.
Yeah, I definitely learned that to always stay focused, because you don't know who's watching and you don't want that to like throw you off. So always stay focused and like have your eye on something and like have your eye on a goal.
Do you all aspire to be professional dancers?
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Training regimes. Tell me, A, what you do individually, and then how many times a week you perform together to maintain your performance. Let's start with you, Emma.
Well, I like train mostly at the studio, because we all have classes together. So we just have like our weekly classes, which are like ballet, technique, progressions, conditioning. And we have like what really helps me is our like improv classes. I think that helps me a lot, because I can like work on different movement. And it shows my creative side a lot. And I think we're all really creative people. So I think having that class also really helps us. And most studios don't really have that. So I think that's one thing that's different about our training.
Yeah, and 2 days a week I go to the gym to help my muscles stay strong so I can lift them.
Yeah, we train Monday to Thursday. So about 4 days a week, and sometimes on the weekends as a trio. But at the studio, it's probably around 5 hours a day, I'd say, that we're constantly training and making sure our technique and choreography and creative side is still.
I'd say we get at least 30 plus hours a week.
Yeah, definitely.
Why do you think dance has become such a phenomenon today? What's the appeal, Emma?
I think it's like for people who like understand it and like actually like look into the story, like it can honestly be quite addicting to watch. Like I could scroll through like a dance page for like hours and just be so like interested in it. So I'd say like the stories behind it and just like the creativity.
Yeah, like every single dance style has like makes you feel some way, and I feel like if people are going through something, they can be inspired by that dance. And I feel like that's why people love watching dance so much, because they make you feel some type of way.
I feel like it's such a mix between an art and a sport, because it's such an athletic activity that we do every day. And so we don't move normally the way normal people do usually. And so I think people just love to watch it and are drawn to the stories.
Best piece of advice to give a young dancer who wants to be in your shoes? Best piece of advice?
When I was younger, I would lose focus a lot. And like, I don't know, I had difficulty staying focused in class, and I'd always try to be like the funny one. So I would just say, like, pushing through it and like just having a hard work ethic, because I know I definitely lost it at times when I was younger, is really helpful. And it's okay to be like funny, and like you can have fun in class, but like some people mistake that for like, oh, if you're funny and fun in class, like you're lazy, like you don't work hard. And like, I don't know, I know even if people say that, just push through and know how you are as it, like, know yourself. And I think that helped me a lot.
I would say the training and the process is very important, because you see on like social media that people are doing all these things, and like that's like not real life. And just to stay true to yourself and remember that your training and the process is the most important thing.
I would say even on the days you feel the worst about your dancing, like you don't feel good about your dancing or anything, those are the days that are most important, because you're growing from your mistakes. And I feel like definitely work ethic is super important, and to never stop dancing just because you're losing your confidence in yourself.
Okay, so Emma, Madison, and Diego, and MDC3, thank you very much for being a small part of Performer Stuff Pro Series, and for helping us to keep entertainment alive, nourished, and full of hope. And for those watching this, please continue to dream big. And while you dream, look out for more Performer Stuff Pro Series coming your way real soon. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much for having us. Yeah.